The green machine from Eugene is bringing national exposure to the Pacific Northwest. Last Saturday, Joey Harrington tossed 4 touchdowns in Oregon's victory over USC. Tailback Maurice Morris is rambling through opponents, averaging 118 yards per game. The Ducks have defended their home turf 18 straight times. Number 19 will make them the favorite for a trip to Pasadena. If you want hype, turn on C-SPAN. This is the real deal, baby. Arizona, Oregon. First place in the Pac-10. Next on Fox Sports Net.
The Oregon Ducks are off to their best conference start in 43 years. If they hope to play in the Rose Bowl, then they'll have to beat Arizona tonight. Welcome inside the College Football Saturday studio in Los Angeles alongside Kellen Winslow and Artie Gigantino. I'm Kevin Frazier, and obviously, guys, huge game. The winner is in the driver's seat.
The winner's in the driver's seat, and tonight for Oregon, that driver's going to be Maurice Morris, their JUCO transfer, Fresno City College. He has come in and really ignited this offense. Take a look at the jumbo here. Big numbers, that's why they call it the jumbo. He's putting up big numbers. 4.6 yards per carry, 25 carries a game. He's a workhorse, 118 yards per game. What it does, Oregon's running game sets up their passing game, makes it a lot easier for that passing of Oregon.
And you know, Arizona's putting up big numbers, but they're putting up big numbers on defense. And they've got to do 3 things tonight in order to win this game. They've got to keep Harrington off balance with shifting and blitzing. They've got to score 1 touchdown on special teams or defense because their offense hasn't been playing great. And lastly, and certainly not least, they've got to come out and do a great job of quieting the crowd by having a ball control offense and take this crowd out of the game.
Who wins this game, real quick?
Arizona wins because of their defense.
Oregon Ducks win the game.
This is the headline of the Eugene Register Guard, and they're basically saying this is the biggest game in the history of Oregon football, not only for the Rose Bowl lead, but also they might get a smile from the BCS.
Steve, a lot of implications tonight. Each team comes in at 5-1, 3-0 in the conference race. So not only do you have the conference implications, the BCS ratings come out Monday. It should be very interesting. Speaking to both coaches tonight before the game, they know it's going to be a dog field.
I have no idea what you said. It's really loud here at Autzen Stadium. But the quarterbacks will be keys. Joey Harrington coming off a tremendous game, best in his career at Oregon last week in beating USC, and a kid by the name of Ortiz Jenkins who does everything.
Joey Harrington comes off a career game against the SC Trojans a week ago. 382 yards, 4 touchdowns. He was elected the Pac-10 Player of the Week. And for Arizona, Ortiz Jenkins, he had a slow start this year, but I'll tell you, he's the giant killer on the road. 7 straight wins on the road, and I think tonight he's got to use his legs to beat the Oregon Duck defense.
Listen to this crowd. They have been chanting Go Ducks the last 3 minutes. Well, the Pac-10 lead is on the line at Autzen Stadium in Eugene. Another sellout crowd of over 44,000 on hand to watch number 21 Arizona and number 7 Oregon.
Steve, the field is just damp, and that's a good thing. And the name of this surface is OmniTurf. It's an artificial surface with sand in the fiber, which is there to help the cleats keep moving. We don't want to see cleats sticking, which could create a devastating injury to a knee or an ankle of a running back. And speaking of running backs, we should see some exciting slashers and dashers tonight. And for Arizona, they do it by committee, led by a true freshman and Clarence Farmer. He's also buddied up with a sophomore, Leo Mills. The two of them have combined for almost 700 yards this season. Now for Oregon, it's junior tailback Maurice Morris. Now here's a guy that's a JUCO transfer, set the national junior college rushing record before he came to Oregon. Now he's averaging 118 yards per game. I just heard a few moments ago that there's only a 20% chance of rain tonight, so we may be in luck. No rain, which means that the surface will hold up and allow these guys to really let it rip.
Oregon won the toss and will receive. Chris Gray will kick off to Alan Amundson, Sonny Cook, and Jermaine Hansbard. Amundson at the 16-yard line. And instead of going straight up the field and maybe getting 5 to 10 yards, he is dropped back inside the 20-yard line, and a host of Wildcats after him. Now here is a look at the Oregon offense. Joey Harrington out of Portland Central Catholic High School, 10 touchdown passes this year, almost 1,400 yards passing. His backs and receivers, Morris over 700 yards rushing. Keenan Howery is his big play wide receiver. Marshawn Tucker is an outstanding split end. His offensive line has been terrific. Jeff Austin in the middle has been terrific, but they have allowed only 5 sacks, the lowest number in the Pac-10 Conference this year. And here they come out on offense. Josh Lyon, the lone running back, and they will give the football to Marshawn Tucker, and Tucker is down near the 19-yard line. I mean, all 4 can do it. Tafoya, Frazier, Thomas, Haroon, outstanding right up front. The linebackers, they are led by Lance Briggs, who leads the team in tackles with 55, also has 3 interceptions. And the secondary, how about Michael Jolivet? 5 interceptions this year to lead the conference. The entire Arizona team last year had only 5 picks. So Jolivet doing the job. And now it is 2nd and 9 after a 1-yard run. Morris now the tailback. And Maurice slashes his way to the 25.
Averaging almost 5 yards a carry, but they have been tough yards all the way.
You remember last week when they beat USC, they designed a defense, the Trojans did, to stop Morris. He had 32 carries, only 85 yards. But Joey Harrington, who you just saw, went off for 382 yards. Big hole, very close to a first down as Morris. Lance Briggs on the tackle.
Special teams, I believe Oregon might have the best special team program in the entire conference. And when we watched their workout yesterday on a Friday, they performed beautifully. And Curtis Dorr, 39-yard average this year, but a lot of times he has not seen a return, or he'll nail it inside the 20.
Yeah, Curtis Dorr does what all great, good punters do, and that's get the ball up and have a great amount of hang time.
Bobby Wade standing at his 35. Dorr hammers it. Wade drifts back, fair catch at his 28-yard line, and that is where Arizona will start their offense. The Wildcats are led by the kid from Long Beach Jordan High School in Southern California, Ortiz Jenkins. Not only 7 touchdowns passing, but 4 running the football, and that is what concerns Oregon. Their backs and receivers, Clarence Farmer, almost 400 yards rushing. Bobby Wade is their big play wide receiver. Brad Brennan is their split end. Reggie Sampei takes over for Bruce Wiggins at the center position. And this is a mishmash at the offensive line because they have lost 2 all-conference players in the game, and Wiggins and Grace, and another Makoa Freitas, the left tackle. Clarence Farmer on the carry, very little. Oregon's defense has been excellent all year long. They're up there in almost every single category. First defensively in scoring, first in total defense, first against the pass.
But who makes the tackle? The unsung hero, Steve Smith.
Farmer slips, and there's that Omni turf that is so old and very slippery. It is 3rd down for Arizona, and they need 17. This crowd is loud. Jenkins will run. Ortiz gets about 7 back. It is 3 and out for the Wildcats. Well, there is Dick Tomey. There's only 1 venue in the Pac-10 where he has never won. Autzen Stadium, 0-4. Keenan Howery on the return. There's the flag. I mean, they were so far inside the halo, they were practically touching skin, and Michael Jolivet,
the winner of this game, will become bowl eligible.
And what we're talking about right here, you got to give the returner a 2-yard halo. Jolivet inside of that 2-yard area, the flag comes out.
5 yards to the final. First down, Oregon.
Joey, 6'4", 220 pounds, the junior from Portland Central Catholic. And he will throw that football, and he skips it. Is it a lateral? Harrington covers it at the 32, and let's see if they call that a lateral.
Harrington tries to get the ball out, and it skips to number 5, Marshawn Tucker.
And they're calling it an incomplete pass. 10:42 remaining first quarter. Harrington looking to throw. Completes it to LaCorey Collins, his tight end.
Steve, they get a big break here. They're able to have that play called back where they don't take a big loss. Take a look. LaCorey Collins is going to end up running a corner route. He comes in. Actually, it came from the other side. It was the backside tight end. A great throw and catch that time by Harrington and Collins.
Now Maurice Morris slashing through, gains about 5-6 yards to the 25-yard line. They'll stay with Morris, but go three wide. Morris, not much there. He somehow snuck through and got a couple before he's wrapped up by Joe Tafoya, the defensive end.
Yeah, Maurice Morris, we heard from Lewis Johnson in the open. He set the national JC record, over 3,700 yards at the JC level, but he's run inside, outside, the toughest yards against some of the toughest run defenses, and he's averaging 118 a game, puts him second in the Pac-10 behind Kenny Simonton.
See Bobby Moore, who would later become Ahmad Rashad, outstanding running back here in Eugene. They go four wide receivers, three to the left side. And Harrington runs the option and gets the first down.
Their red zone offense has been tremendous this year as well. They've run an awful lot of plays, and that scared Rich Ellerson, the Arizona defensive coordinator.
Joey with the blitz on him, and they finally wrap him up. Brandon Nash, who came from his strong safety position, was able to sack him along with Adrian Cope.
He knew he was going to have to mix things up. Oregon's offensive line have given up only 5 sacks all year. Arizona comes in leading the conference with 22 sacks. Make that 23 for them. But the Oregon offensive line has done a great job protecting the passer. And to Harrington's defense, he's throwing the ball away when he needs it.
Well, he was outstanding last week, throwing for 382 in the victory over USC. Second and 16. They'll roll the pocket left side. Harrington downfield. And it is caught for the touchdown, Marshawn Tucker.
Been able to jump out on people early again. Oh, they move the pocket. Morris almost knocks down Harrington, and they just throw a skinny post inside to Marshawn Tucker. Once again, the timing aspect just nails for the Oregon Ducks. That was Tucker's first touchdown catch this year.
And that is surprising. It is good. Oregon takes the early lead over Arizona. Oregon has won 18 consecutive home games here in the city of Eugene. Marshawn Tucker, 56-yard drive and 7 plays. And on the 25-yard line on 2nd and 16, Tucker with his first score of the year 2000. Now the kickoff. Gary Love. Gary Love, big hole, out past the 40 to the 42-yard line. Now let's go to our College Football Saturday studio for a game day with Kevin Frazier.
Guys, the only other game featuring two top 25 teams today, UCLA and Oregon State. Patrick McCall finds a hole. He is gone. Oregon State completes the L.A. sweep for the first time ever, beating both USC and UCLA.
Kevin, how about that? They're bowl eligible. The Beavers are 6-1. They're 3-1 in conference play. Congratulations to Dennis Erickson's crew.
First time for Oregon State. First time for the Oregon schools as well, beating the L.A. schools.
Jenkins deep for Bobby Wade. Incomplete.
That's the only chance you have winning up here is with a veteran quarterback.
You're right, and he is a veteran, a senior. Started on and off the last 4 years. He whips it, and he threw it right past Andre Thurman. Thurman dives for it, but I believe this will be an incomplete pass. Oregon State, we talked about their victory at the Rose Bowl. Arizona State has to go overtime, so how about the Cougars? Their last two losses in overtime to Arizona, now to Arizona State. First time ever the Trojans have started 0-4. Jenkins, 3rd and 10. Ortiz, all kinds of time. Now it arose, and he's sacked back at the 37. Seth McEwen.
This is no first for the Oregon Duck defense. They just maul you defensively. Great downfield coverage. Then they come off the edge. McEwen, Saul, Patu.
He runs away. This has been very successful. They've done this style of punt like five times this year. Howery has a great lane on the right side. And Keenan finally cut down near the 32, and somebody's helmet came rolling off. They're flying all over the place here at Autzen. You want to see a guy get ripped?
Special teams, just keep an eye on number 8 right here. You thought that only happened to Keyshawn Johnson? Oh, my man. Oh, Wes Mallard, number 18, laid. Oh, my goodness. Oh.
Michael Jolovet got it in the jaw.
One play special
teams. Wesley Mallard really slammed him.
Ooh.
From the 31, Harrington to Maurice Morris. Not much. Arizona against the run has been outstanding this year. They've allowed only 70 yards rushing, but against the pass, they are 9th in the conference. And Harrington may go back to the air right here. Play action. Incomplete, and it was right there in the numbers for Jason Willis.
Mike Bellotti's offense has just been converting third downs, number 1 in the conference in total offense, 44 wins since 1995, most by any Pac-10 team. Bellotti's done a nice job retaining that home surface, too, with a lot of W's.
3 wide, that means we'll see a blitz. Harrington picks it up, fires, incomplete. Broken up beautifully by David Hinton.
This is what the front 7 does for you, too. They put a lot of pressure on Harry. They're trying to get the ball to Willis on third down. Willis, his mistake is not coming back to the football. Hinton makes a great play, and then he's popped by his own teammate.
Curtis Doerr to Bobby Wade. Wade, fair catch, 32-yard line. Timeout of the field, 5:16 remaining. First Verizon presents First and 10 all season long on Fox Sports Net College Football Saturday. Verizon, making the world of communications a whole lot simpler. That's that yellow line where Arizona needs to go for a first down. Clarence Farmer, the true freshman, up past the 35 to the 36, gain of about 3.
But they're number 1 in pass defense, which they convert that total to be a number 1 in total defense.
Farmer, nothing. The speed of that defense. Let's go down to the field to Lewis Johnson.
Well, Steve, here's an update on that devastating hit that Michael Jolivet took a few moments ago. Remember seeing him come across the field and then catching the helmet right here. Oh, and his helmet goes up in the air. Jolivet on his back there, and he's still on the bench right now on the sideline. They're working on him on the inside of his lip and the outside of his lip. Look at the gauze pads and all the blood. They still haven't stopped the bleeding yet, Steve.
And he is a very dangerous defensive back, very important to Arizona's success. It's third down and 6. Jenkins. Ortiz scrambling. No. They're still looking for a first down. Oregon says they got the loose football, but I believe the ground caused it. Matt Smith, that big middle linebacker who goes 6'4", 245. He's the guy who made the hit on Jenkins. Boy, there's a big argument here. Why is this taking so long?
Oh, there's a big powwow on the field. The ground cannot cause a fumble, and that's what the line judge is talking to Gordon Reese, the referee, about. We'll hear from the source.
That is 2 plays now that have gone against Dick Tomey. The lateral, and now this fumble. Let's see.
Ortiz Jenkins on 3rd and 6, scrambling. The ball comes out. Matt Smith not only makes the tackle. Watch number 49. Oh, what a great play. And right there, he recovers the ball as well. That's a great heads-up play. Matt Smith, once again, leading the team in tackles, really their emotional leader, just a great player. Played a couple years professionally in a baseball and
with the Kansas City Royals. He was a pitcher.
Came back, and he's still a non-scholarship player, so obviously he's got the Muni funds working for him.
Well, Harrington's going for the home run. And he had Tucker all alone, and Tucker didn't find the football. Sportsnet. Maybe we could hook him up with Michael Jolivet because they were hit about the same way. Johnson by the Lions. There's the throw. Tucker with the catch. It's a first down, Oregon.
Harrington, a three-step drop. Watch Tucker, just a short post. And Harrington, there's no opportunity for a sack here. Quick three-step drop. Ball's out. First down.
Now Morris. How about this 1-2 threat that Oregon has on the ground? Morris has gone for over 700 yards rushing. And Harrington, who's becoming one of the best quarterbacks not only in the conference, but in the nation.
And I think Oregon has two great quarterbacks. Joey Harrington, of course, and then don't forget A.J. Feely, who's on the bench. He started 8 games a year ago. There's A.J. Feely, number 7, the senior out of Ontario, Oregon. And I'll tell you what, he is as good a player as there is in the country. It's just Harrington's playing great right now, and he's 9-1 as a starter.
Second and 8. Morris is hit. Joe Tafoya came from the side, and wow, he took him down hard.
One of the top tacklers in the nation coming from that defensive end position, just coming down hard.
Third and 10. Big third down defensively for the Cats. Harrington blitzes on. Joey is sacked at the 26-yard line. Another loss of 2. It'll be fourth down and 11.
Bring a lot of heat.
They fake it. Harrington completes it. Josh Line is stopped short of a first down.
Bilotti yesterday about risk and reward. They faked a punt a week ago against SC in their own territory in the first quarter. All of a sudden, you see Line come out of the backfield. He's just going to run in the flat. He's wide open. He slips on the turf. You see the sand come up. Right there, it worked against them that time. David Hinton in the corner making a good play defensively.
This is a very, very poor surface, and this time it hurts Oregon. So Arizona takes over, down 7-0. Leo Mills is the new running back. He had a great game in the victory in 3 overtimes against Washington State. Reverse, Bobby Wade. Bobby Wade sneaks free. He's to midfield. Bounce 32-yard line.
Charlie Dickey, the offensive line coach, right there with him. Something on the interior. It looks like right there they're going to call it. They wrapped up Zach Frieder pretty well. And Bobby Wade, you see his athleticism and what he can do.
They already have 59 this year, 3 tonight. First and 16 for Jenkins.
And Steve, what you have to do on first down right here, just get a positive gain. Get 5 yards, be happy, line up on second and 11.
They'll run it. They won't get those 5 yards. They'll lose a couple.
Every team that's been a victim up here, they feel like they're playing uphill. And Rick Neuheisel at the University of Washington said, hey, we felt like we were playing uphill the whole game.
Second and 17. Jenkins fires, completes it at the 22-yard line. Very close. He still needs about 3 or 4 for a first down. But that is the end of the first quarter. You know, Washington and Oregon State had to come from behind to win their games and go to 3-1. Incredible wins there. Arizona State wins. They're now 5-2 overall and 2-2 in conference play. And Stanford, an incredible win at home and homecoming against USC. Last second touchdown pass from Chris Lewis to Jamie McCullum. Here it is 3rd and 3. Arizona looking for their first down. Jenkins loops it. Completes it, first down to Brad Brennan.
All right, Steve, here's an update on Arizona cornerback Michael Jolivet. We saw him take that devastating shot to the chin, and a few moments ago they walked him out of the stadium. I ran out to see what was going on. They were putting Jolivet in a car. He is headed to Sacred Heart Hospital, which is about 10 minutes from Autzen Stadium. His chin is split wide open, Steve, and he's going to have to take some stitches. Not sure if he'll return.
Wow. That is the kid who leads the Pac-10 conference in interceptions with five. So Jermaine Chapman, the junior from Compton, California, must really step up when Arizona's on defense. Jenkins fires, complete. Bobby Wade, he is so dangerous. We saw his game against Ohio. Let's see if Jenkins runs that option. No, he's going to run the fullback. Very short gain of about a yard. Getting him a little closer to that first down line. Third and two. Jenkins timeout. This place really got loud. Ortiz takes time with 13:24 remaining in the first half. Wow.
And Steve, Dino Babers, the offensive coordinator, said they had to be physical tonight. Third and two. I think you might stay on the ground here and see if you can punch it over for a first down.
Jenkins looking at the official when he starts the clock. Reverse, Wade, they stretch it out and stop him! Ryan Mitchell. Hey, this place isn't Autzen Stadium anymore. It's Awesome Stadium.
I agree.
This crowd just gets so loud that your wide receivers can't hear.
Well, they try to slip Bobby Wade around the corner, and the defense just keeps pushing it out to the sideline. Mitchell does a great job keeping containment, and they take Wade down.
Chris Palak. Howry. Fair catch. 20-yard line. Harrington runs Morris. Big hole. Maurice. First down. Very close to that horizon line. Just past the 30.
Now the number one tackler for the Wildcats, Lance Briggs. Keep an eye on him right here. He's going to get tagged by the fullback, Josh Lyon. And just a good block. Stays on the block. Maurice Morris able to follow the block. Get up inside between the tackles and another nice gain on first down.
Gain of nine, second and one. Both teams have had a rough time running the football. That's the longest run for both sides. Now they run Josh Lyon. He will get the first down out near the 34-yard line. But Oregon, right now, running the football, 13 carries for 25 yards. Arizona, 11 carries, no yards. 26 yards rushing for the Ducks.
Well, that's pretty amazing right there. Arizona unable to rush at all tonight. The big goose egg.
Well, two of the stingiest defenses in the Pac-10 Conference battling. Oregon, number one, allowing 15 points per game. Arizona, number two, 16 points per game, despite giving up 47 last week in a three overtime victory over Washington State. Morris tried to find a hole, but Keone Frazier closed it up quickly. He's the junior from Hawaii who's really fast. Big number 56. 6'1", 282.
Arizona's front seven, as Jeff Tedford, the offensive coordinator, Lorian said, they're very unconventional. They play a little double eagle flex. It's hard to get hats on people. They do a lot of stemming, a lot of movement before the snap of the ball, and it creates a lot of confusion for the offensive line. And hey, credit that Arizona defense. When they're moving around, they're doing it quick.
Second and 10. Morris breaks a tackle. Bust left side and hammers Chapman out of bounds. Boy, he lowered a shoulder. He is running with more confidence. When he came out of junior college, we expected great things, but he was slow to develop, and now he's running like a pack mule.
Well, and number 27, Lance Briggs, had a shot at him in the backfield, and Chapman, number 23, pushed him out of bounds. Get a look at Mo Morris. Oregon record after six games is held by Bobby Moore back in 71, but Mo Morris is climbing the ladder.
And he's a popular man in his family. Eight of his brothers and sisters and his grandma and grandpa and his mom came out here to Eugene, Oregon to live with him. Harrington going deep. Incomplete, intended for Keenan Howery. Oregon outgaining Arizona, tripling them. But last week, Jenkins watches double lateral to Melosi Leonard, back to Jenkins, and then Ortiz runs it in.
What a great call. The first play of that triple overtime game. They knew they had that play set up.
Jason Gesser brought them back for Washington State and tied it up once again. Leo Mills scored two touchdowns in that overtime, but Antonio Pierce had the interception at the goal line to wrap it up, and the Wildcats beat the Cougars 53-47. Cougars lost their second overtime game tonight. Ortiz Jenkins threw for 236 yards, the most yards passing he has had this year, three touchdowns, but how about 61 rushing?
I think that's what he has to do tonight as well. He's got to have at least that many yards on the ground. Tonight's stats, he's only 3 for 5 for 39 yards. On the phone with Dino Babers, but I'm sure they're just saying, hey, let's be patient. It's a close game. Right now, the defense has to step up and hold the Oregon
Ducks. You're right, because that's why they're winning. They're winning because they're plus 13 in turnovers this year, and the Wildcat defense has to come up with a pick or a forced fumble. Harrington with time. Incomplete. Looking for his tight end, Justin Beal. Breaking it up, Jermaine Chapman, who is the guy who has to replace Michael Jolivet, who's gone to the hospital to have his mouth cleaned up.
And what this defense, the problems it poses for the offense, Steve, you have to worry about protection. You don't want to get your quarterback blindsided or ear-holed by the Arizona defense, so you got to keep some extra people in. What Oregon's doing is max protecting. And what you do, you play into the hands of the Oregon defense. You only have a two-man route or a three-man route. Right now they have three wides on the field, but they're going to keep both backs in the block.
Arizona showing blitz, and here they come. Harrington drifts, and they throw the screen. And how about the Cats reading that? Anthony Thomas, a defensive tackle, rolled over and made the hit on the running back.
Oregon's unafraid to run the screen on any part of the field, and right there, good recognition by the Arizona defense, and they just clamp it down.
Yeah, I like Arizona's poise in this game.
Pride and poise is what Dick Tomey talked about, and that comes with a lot of senior leadership and also some big play leadership by a lot of the teammates of the Arizona Wildcats.
Curtis Doar. Bobby Wade inside the 10. What is he fair catching it for inside the 10?
They've landed on the podium to accept Academy Awards. Eight have taken up residence in the Oregon Governor's Mansion. Two won the Nobel Prize. 180 were named Fulbright Scholars. 67 have gone to the Olympics. And one was the first female to cross the North and South Poles. Not bad for a bunch of ducks. The University of Oregon. Spread your wings.
There was a time where punters didn't have to be that athletic. Curtis Doar is 6'2", 215, and hey, better be athletic after this confrontation.
Well, Curtis Doar, Coach Tomey's telling, play hard. Hey, play hard. But Curtis Doar, he's 6'2", 215. He'll wrestle you a little bit.
Arizona has to start their offense backed up, and the crowd really loud. Jenkins to Farmer. Nothing. They'll lose another yard. Now 12 carries for minus 1 yard by an Arizona running offense that averages 157 yards per game.
One of the things that Dick Tomey told me tonight, beyond needing good field position, is they got to spring Clarence Farmer tonight. But when you start at your own 23, the average field position of opponents, and look where they start here, that's just a mistake by Bobby Wade.
Second and 11. This time, Farmer smashes his way out to the 8-yard line. So they're now out of the minus stage. What do they have? 14 carries now for 3 yards rushing.
Well, you see how important Curtis Doerr, the punter of Oregon, is, because in this game of field position, he had a great punt. Bobby Wade made a bad decision catching the ball inside the five, but now you force Arizona into that long yardage situation again on third down. Third and eight, Matt Smith trying to get his troops fired up.
Jenkins looping it downfield. Intercepted, 22-yard line. Rasuli Webster. They came in plus 13 turnover margin. In this game, they are minus 2.
And Steve, Nick Aliotti, the defensive coordinator of the Oregon Ducks, told us about Rasuli Webster. A great, hard-working young man playing really good defensively at free safety. Rasuli Webster making just a huge play on third down against number 16, Ortiz Jenkins.
Tried to loop it to his tight end, but Webster read it beautifully, and now Oregon has great field position at the Arizona 22. They run Morris to the 21. He is pulled back by Keone Frazier and friends.
Boy, this is what hurts you, the turnovers. Arizona plus 11, number one in the conference. Oregon not too far behind. Oregon State got past UCLA today, too. They are awfully tough, awfully fast defense that Dennis Erickson has as well.
Well, they're going to have to come up with some picks. I mean, they have forced 14 fumbles this year, second in the conference in interceptions with 11, first in forced fumbles. Harrington, all kinds of time, fires right side over the head of a wide open Jason Willis, but you give a guy 5-6 seconds and somebody's going to get open.
Arizona asking a lot of their defense right now with the turnover. Harrington did have great protection trying to get the ball over to Willis. Ball just overthrown, this time just jump as well. Jason Willis, 6'1", 190 pounds, unable to climb the ladder. Third down and eight facing the Ducks, but you're in good field position. At least you have a chance at a field goal here. If you're Harrington, don't take a sack. Take a shot down the field.
Big defensive stand for Arizona. They're showing blitz from the inside. Harrington steps up, rifles. Touchdown, Marshawn Tucker.
Are ones that utilize everybody. Harrington, Keenan Howery, they lined him up on the opposite side. He took two guys his way, and then all of a sudden you got Marshawn Tucker with his second touchdown of the night. And that's the second one this year for number 5.
Up and good. Kevin, it is indeed, and Oregon so impressive at home. And I'm always wondering why Oregon is never talked about for the BCS rankings. I mean, I heard today where people were talking about Miami going to the national championship game. Hey, Oregon beat Washington, who beat Miami. Put the Ducks a little higher. There's a fumble. Arizona recovers, though, at the 25-yard line. Larry Kroom. Whew.
Well, we'll talk about Oregon to BCS because the Oregon offense, they put Keenan Howery down here. He takes two people with him. All of a sudden, Marshawn Tucker is going to run a skinny post. Harrington fires away. But this Oregon offense, Steve, they've been in the top 20 the last 6 of 7 years. Mike Pilotti has it going on.
Yes, he does. They only needed 22 yards after the interception by Rasuli Webster. Tucker came in without a touchdown this year and has 2. Jenkins, look at this defense.
they're all over the place.
Yeah.
I mean, they've got Kevin Mitchell, who's 5 feet 10 inches tall, playing linebacker. He shot the middle and was able to bring down the running back Larry Croom so quickly, and Matt Smith joined him.
Galliotti's got defensive coordinator for the Ducks. And he'll tell you, they don't have any superstars, but I'll tell you right there, take a look. That is great job. Only giving up 15 points and 289 yards a game. Ouch.
Jenkins looping it. Bobby Wade, first down catch to the 46-yard line. ...19 yards in the play. Bobby Wade is coming off his best game with 6 catches, 112 yards against Washington State with this grab against Rashad Bowman.
Bobby Wade averaging 18 yards a catch on the season. Just a little fade route up the sideline. I think you still got to weave him in that mix a little bit more, Bobby Wade.
Jenkins started shotgun, now moves over center. They can't hear him. Ortiz to a wide open receiver. And look at this, Larry Croom is gone. They split out the running back and they throw it to him, and Ortiz could not have thrown a prettier pass. 58 yards.
Steve, I think Dino Babers right there, the offensive coordinator, he spread everybody out. Before the game, I asked him, I said, Dino, you're going to run a lot of all empty backfield, aren't you? He said, well, I don't know, but that's how you can go get after the Oregon Duck defense. Spread everybody out.
14-7. Arizona gets right back in the game on a 58-yard scoring pass from Ortiz Jenkins to his running back Larry Croom. Now Arizona to kick off. Trying to kick off away from the deep men, but they get it to him about the 8-yard line, and streaking through is Jermaine Hanspark, and Hanspark passed the 40 to the 42, and making a touchdown saving tackle is Jarvie Wooster. Let's see that Larry Croom touchdown again, Tom.
Larry Croom, one of the tailbacks in that rotation, he lined up as a wing right in the backfield, just scooted out. Nobody picked him up. Ortiz Jenkins sat back with a lot of time that time, surveyed the field, and found his open man Croom streaking down the middle of that Oregon secondary and able to put the ball right on the mark.
Big play drive, 76 yards in 3 plays.
And look at where Oregon starts again.
Great field position. Harrington stepping up. He'll be sacked. There is a flag down. Have to go to Kansas City. Arrowhead Stadium is hard to pull away a win.
I'm convinced those guys in the studio aren't drinking decaf coffee either.
They are funny. Here is Maurice Morris. He gets back 10 plus 4 more. Jarvie Wooster on the tackle.
Mo Morris coming in, averaging 118 a game. Once again, off tackle. Nice block by the fullback, Josh Line, and he gets on the edge. That's usually where the Arizona defense can hurt you. They'll push out to the sideline. Usually can't grab the edge. Nice job by Morris.
He's got 59 yards now and 12 carries, so he's nearing the 800-yard rushing mark this season. Ken Simonton of Oregon State went over 1,000 yards rushing in the Beavers' victory over UCLA. Harrington deep. Intercepted. Where was his wide receiver? It looked like Tucker just stopped. And Jermaine Chapman, who replaced Michael Jolivet, plays like Jolivet and picks it off.
Now remember, in this 18-game home winning streak of the Oregon Ducks, Arizona has not fallen victim. They were not part of this 18. So they want to come up here and break the streak, but this is the kind of challenge right here you need, and the kind of opportunity you need to fall in your lap. Oh, there the ball comes out of the sky to Chapman.
And it was interesting talking to Dick Tomey on Thursday, and we asked him about the crowd, about Autzen Stadium and the environment. He goes, that's not a big deal. And he was trying to avoid it at all costs. He did not want his team to have an excuse. He said, hey, guys, you got to go out there and play. There is a flag down on the field. But Dick Thomey, he always says one of his keys to victory.
Illegal block in the back by the Arizona. 10 yards. End of the run. First down.
Well, Gordon had a little smile on his face. He's enjoying this one. But
to your point, Steve, about Dick Thomey, I asked him, I said, Coach, before the game, I said, hey, are the players hearing you? And he said, you know what? He goes, Rams, the way you know, he goes, you start hearing and reading the players kind of saying what you've been saying, and they've been able to do that. Take a look at Dick Thomey and Eugene. A lot of L's.
The only Pac-10 venue he has yet to win at. But he said one of the keys, don't let outside things affect the game. The fans, the stadium, the weather. Jenkins, play action pass. Going deep. Incomplete. There's the flag. Pass interference. Brandon Marshall was almost mugged by Rashad Bowman.
Brandon Marshall, another JC guy out of Palomar, down towards San Diego against one-on-one against Rashad Bowman. And Ortiz Jenkins threw the ball late down the field, which usually is trouble, but he's got a big arm and he's able to get the ball out, but defense. Bowman just runs right through him.
15 yards, previous spot, automatic first down.
So Bowman gets a penalty, and that will give Arizona much better field position. They get out of that. Well, both end zones are extremely loud, but when you get inside the 10, as an offense, you can't hear your signals. You just got to look for the football to be snapped into Jenkins' hands.
I don't think you can hear it midfield either.
Three wide set. They're spreading them all out, Tom. Leo Mills. Boy, he is cracked right after a yard gain. Let's go down to the field to Lewis Johnson.
Well, Steve, here's a chance to clarify even further how bad the mouth injury to Arizona cornerback Michael Jolivet is. Right there, that shot he took, he was hit so hard that the flesh on the inside of his mouth was torn away from his gum line. He's even got some loose teeth. We're told that at the hospital they've had to call in a dental specialist to try and help with the repair work that Jolivet will need in his mouth.
What a shame, because that is a huge loss. Dick Thomey said this is a kid who is just dead serious about football. He's a great practice player, and they feel he's going to have a wonderful future at Arizona. Hurt last year, and that's why they had to redshirt him. He broke his ankle just 2 days into practice. Bobby Wade cannot escape Garrett Sable. You know, we were talking with Mike Bellotti about the guys who are the fierce workers. They may not be guys who play at the next level, but he said Steve Smith, Garrett Sable, and Jed Boyce have been incredible workers, and they lead the rest of the team.
Well, Garrett Sable just saved a touchdown when he tackled Bobby Wade on that last play, because if he breaks Sable's tackle, he's gone. Third down.
Oregon blitzing. They're bringing seven. Ortiz. Incomplete, intended for Melosi Leonard. Keenan Howery standing at his 25-yard line. They roll to the right. It did not work earlier. It works this time. Joey Harrington will be sacked.
They played a little more zone this year than in years past. In years past, a lot of man and man free, but this year they're working in a lot of zone defense.
They run Maurice Morris, who escapes outside, and then he is tackled by Adrian Cote. He came back 2 weeks later.
Any guy that's been in the service, you know. fearless.
Former Marine, now former walk-on. They gave him a scholarship. Look at, he's got the American flag on that knee brace. That's a U.S. Marine. Semper Fi, brother. Third and 13. Harrington has it knocked down. Joe Tafoya.
Tafoya comes off the edge. just working. Boy, they had a mismatch. Tafoya ended up, they had a fullback trying to block him that time. Second team all Pac-10 a year ago. 21 and a half career sacks. 10 last year led the Arizona Wildcat team.
What's that Dick Tomey statement? It's about a bunch of guys named Joe. There's a blocked punt! And Arizona has it. Adrian Koch. He has had a great last couple of minutes. There is a flag down on the play, though. Adrian Koch, a 5 foot 9 inch linebacker.
Well, Curtis Doerr usually gets it off quick, but Koch came right up the middle, just smothered the ball that time. And they are very adept at blocking kicks.
Was no flag. They picked it up. A chance for the tie. 37 seconds remaining in the first half. Jenkins eludes the blitz, but he cannot escape the rest of the Oregon defense. Jason Nicolau, Saul Patu combining for the sack. Timeout, Arizona. Oregon defense has been playing very, very well, but an interception led to a touchdown, and now a block punt has helped out the Cats. Ortiz Jenkins was sacked. And then Ortiz threw an interception. Bobby Wade. Here's the Jenkins pick by Rasuli Webster that led to the Marshawn Tucker touchdown for a 14-0 lead. Now a turnover led to an Arizona score, and now a block punt.
And Don Pelham over there, he's trying to get his troops fired up. They came in 12th in pass defense, 15th in scoring defense, 18th in total defense in the country. Of course, leading the Pac-10 in a lot of categories, but you saw how important special teams is and execution. Right now, Arizona, again, with three wideouts, and a back in the backfield.
Brennan goes motion. Jenkins shotgun. Ortiz end zone. Incomplete, and right now, they need positive yardage to get into field goal range, and it looked like Ryan Mitchell went into the band. And Ryan Mitchell gets hurt.
Well, you have a really short sideline here at Oregon, and it's off. I bet you that's the last time they'll have the drums sitting over here in the corner. He just smashes into the oil. Boy, he got hung up as well. Ball goes sailing out. Boy, that's awfully dangerous.
Look how close it is, though. You can't do that.
I'm worried about that tank. Oh, my goodness. Now, Mike Bellotti will make sure that that's not anywhere to be found.
I believe that's going to be changed. It's a good thing he didn't run into the piano player's area. 21. Listen to this crowd. Play action. Jenkins will run for positive and gets it inside the 20-yard line to the 17, where free safety Rasuli Webster makes the tackle. Had a wonderfully played first half, though. Timeout called by Arizona.
Steve, we saw Mitchell go into the band over there. He sliced up his fingers on a couple of the cymbals. They've been attending to it. He ran out on the field a moment ago, but the trainers made him come back because they had to take care of some of the blood on his uniform.
Thank you, Lewis. Mitchell down the sideline as Sean Keel will try and go for a field goal that is just inside the 25-yard line. 5 of 7 this year. A terrific first half here at Autzen Stadium in Eugene, Oregon, 14-10. Number 7, Oregon leads number 21, Arizona. Here's the kickoff, Allen Amundsen at the 1-yard line. Amundsen flashes through and is out past the 40. Well, there he is, Rasuli Webster. And Ryan Mitchell, it was Ryan Mitchell, said, you know, last time I went to band camp, this happened.
Oh. Boy.
That's the best play by a Pac-10 band since Stanford in 82 versus Cal. Dick Tomey said, hey, let's run our wide receiver into the percussion section. There's the fullback, Josh Lyon, running, and that will be the final play of the first half, and a wonderful game it is. The battle for the Pac-10 lead. Mike Bellotti against Dick Tomey. Marshawn Tucker, his wide receiver, scored two touchdowns. This is number two from 20 yards out. And Joey Harrington with 12 touchdown passes this year. Oregon by four at Autzen Stadium in Eugene.
What will you talk to you guys about when here at halftime?
Well, I'm going to apologize for that last 3 points that I gave, and we should have run the football on third down. That's my fault. You know, we're playing good. We can't give up big plays, but we know Arizona's very explosive, and we've got to take better advantage of field position when we get it.
Okay, thanks, Coach. I know you want to get in the locker room, so we'll let you get there.
The great thing about, you know, I just really, my opinion of this coach at Oregon, Bellotti, just went way up, and I heard a coach apologize
all the time
for making a bad call. That is so refreshing. Yeah. So many coaches put players in bad positions. I like this guy now.
And if I could be sentimental here for a second.
Do it over there.
This is what college football is all about. Two teams like this in an atmosphere like this. This is college football.
Number 7, Oregon, leading number 21, Arizona, 14-10. Steve Fisiak, along with Tom Ramsey. Both UCLA and Washington came into Autzen Stadium, and they were intimidated a bit. Arizona, great deal of poison that first half.
Well, we knew we'd have a great game. We do. And Arizona is unfazed by the crowd and really that Oregon defense. Arizona's been able to spread them out a little bit. They haven't rushed the ball real effectively, but Ortiz Jenkins has shown a lot of poise and making some big plays along the way.
And as you look at the first half stats, 17 carries for only 1 yard rushing by Arizona.
Yeah, that is huge right there. Only 1 yard. And keep an eye on the turnover battle, too. Time of possession usually falls in Oregon's favor as well.
Guys, I talked to Dick Tomey just a moment ago, and I asked him about the environment, if it has anything to do with their ability or their lack of ability to get some things going, and he said not at all. But again, he hammered in the locker room that he's upset that they don't have a running game. That has to happen here in the second half. And the other thing that he mentioned is better tackling on defense. He said he was all over the guys about that, Steve.
At the 27-yard line, Arizona brings it out. First half possessions for Arizona. Look how poorly they started. A couple of punts, then a fumble, another punt, an interception. Then they went on that three-play, 76-yard drive. The pass to Kroon for the score. They punted another time. Then they blocked the punt, and it resulted in 3 points.
But, Steve, I think they knew coming in there was going to be some series when they were three and out. That's sure enough. That's what happened, but they've been resilient.
Clarence Farmer is the running back. Jenkins has to scramble. Now Ortiz will run it past the 30 up near the 34-yard line. He needs to get to the 37 for a play. In 22 years of Pac-10 football, Arizona has never produced a first-team all-conference quarterback. Jenkins hands off. They run it first down and more. Clarence Farmer past midfield to the 45-yard line. Garrett Sable on the tackle with Rasuli Webster.
Clarence Farmer up the middle. 6 foot, 225-pound big freshman out of Houston, Texas.
How about that? 20 yards in that run. He had 7 carries, no yards in the first half. Brennan in motion. Play action. Jenkins, plenty of time. Deep. Incomplete to Bobby Wade. Great coverage by Rashad Bowman.
Man, Jenkins got great protection again, and then he just unloads it as he gets unloaded upon. But watch the ball come down and hit Bobby Wade right in the basket.
That would have been a tough catch as he was wrestling with Bowman. They fake the reverse. They run to the left side, and there's about 7 green jerseys, so Jenkins will lose the yardage, about 3.
Ortiz Jenkins just able to stay alive there. He eludes, I think, number 98, Jason Nicolau, and came in with 4 sacks and almost was able to spring 3, but Webster finally there to bring him down.
play has really worked for him. He bounces it inside the 20-yard line to the 8. Howry brings it out to the 19-yard line. The number 7 team in the nation, the Oregon Ducks, with a 14-10 lead over the Arizona Wildcats. Oregon and Arizona both with identical 5-1 records, 3-0 in conference play. Victory means the conference lead and an edge towards the Rose Bowl or the BCS. Harrington will give it to Maurice Morris, and he slams the middle, one of his healthiest runs up the middle. But because of the pressure from Anthony Thomas and Keone Frazier, he has had to get much of his work outside, only 8 yards up the middle. He has 21 to the outside right, 29 outside left. But Frazier at 282 and Anthony Thomas at 290 are outstanding defensive tackles. Morris again. They'll need another yard and a half for a first down. And there is an injured Wildcat on the field, and it appears to be Adrian Cope. See that MCL injury he has on his right knee. Boy, he is a fierce competitor. We told you, a former Marine, now a former walk-on. He's a guy who fought for our country in Somalia and Bosnia and wanted so badly to play this senior season. Only 5'9", 216. But in their defense, they'll play him all over the field. Now they'll have to bring in probably Joe Siofeta. Harrington gives it to Morris. He slides forward, and he gets the first down.
And Anthony Thomas, 58, those two defensive tackles, they're right at the point of attack. One goes low, one goes high. Thomas trying to neutralize his man, and that's just a war of bench presses there.
He's now 69 yards rushing on 16 carries. He'll go right back to Morris, and he slams inside. The one thing offensive coordinator Jeff Tedford told us was they would be patient with the running game. There's the option. Morris is cut down. Oh, what a play by Lance Briggs, the middle linebacker. They show blitz left side, but will they come? Yep. Antonio Pierce coming, but he's picked up by the tight end. Now, Harrington will run, and Joey slices forward, and I think he got the first down.
Boy, the toughness of Harrington. Very apparent there. Movement in the pocket. Antonio Pierce, 45. Anthony Thomas, 58. Then he starts pointing out some blockers, and he picks up a couple great blocks. Idris Haroon gets blocked. Boy, number 23, Jermaine Chapman, had a chance to come up and put a licking on him, but Harrington, all 220, gets the first down.
So they go back to Maurice. He cuts to the outside. Nice game. Adrian Koch back in the field for Arizona. Morris runs, and he is hit, knocked down by Lance Briggs, that middle linebacker. Again, Arizona showing blitz. They run the option, and they will not get it. It's over your head, Bobby. Let it go. It will go out of bounds near the 22-yard line, so not a punt that Mike Bellotti is familiar with from Curtis Doar, but still, it is the Ducks leading by 4 with 8:31 remaining in the third quarter. Jenkins comes out at quarterback. Clarence Farmer remains the lone setback. Double tight end play action. Jenkins going deep for Bobby Wade. Almost intercepted by Steve Smith.
A great wrinkle that time. Arizona using a 3 tight end set. They put Brandon Manumaliuna in motion. And Ortiz Jenkins had Eli Winnick wide open. Steve, he elected to get a little greedy, go downtown. Steve Smith once again steps up, makes a great play for the Ducks.
Coaching staff loves his work habits. 3 wide to the left side. Jenkins will run it. He's got some room. Ortiz. Oh, I thought he'd cut inside, and he had about 5-6 more yards, but he ran right into Smith.
Steve Smith played so well a week ago against the Trojans. Had a couple big plays defensively, a couple pass is broken up, and this is just a great play by him. Once again, he goes low on the big man, Ortiz Jenkins, and Jenkins upset it himself that time for not cutting it up.
First down, 39-yard line.
He'll sit down in the hole. Oregon gives him a zone defense. Ortiz Jenkins just waits for him to get open, and all of a sudden he just fires a bullet right in there, right on number 13. First down, caps.
61 career catches in an injury-plagued career. Ortiz steps up in trouble. Saul Patu will not let him go.
Oh, the Battle of New York and the Battle of Missouri going on.
Not much.
Oregon is so tough. They got teams pinned back deep. Third and 12 to bring someone off the edge. That was a 21st sack in his career for Saul Patu.
Bobby Wade and Brad Brennan wide to the right. Jenkins sacked again, back at the 30. Zach Prater.
Defensive line really got a great push that time on a young, inexperienced offensive line. The fourth sack tonight on Ortiz Jenkins. The pocket just collapsed.
Keenan Howry standing at his 32, awaiting Chris Palak's punt. Well, they interfered with Keenan, and he may have run into his own man. He did, so it rolls inside the 20-yard line, and Adrian Koch will kill it at the 15. That is offensive line coach Charlie Dickey, and we were watching him in that huddle, and he was telling his troops, be tough, be tougher than they are. Right now, Arizona trails by four. Joey Harrington will break that huddle and bring his troops up to the line of scrimmage at the 16-yard line. Maurice Morris, lone setback. Maurice gets the call, the carry, and he is wrapped up by Tafoya again.
Inside, watch him shoot down the line of scrimmage. Makes a hit in the backfield on Morris. Shuts him down on first down.
Teddy Bruschi, one of their best ever, played in the early 90s. Joey Harrington back to the air, and it is incomplete.
And Steve, that was Joe Tafoya again. He got a hand on the ball that time.
That's the second time he's blocked one.
Pick number 99. I asked Jeff Tedford, the offensive coordinator, before the game. I said, hey, are you going to game plan against Tafoya? And he said, no, not really. And I thought, boy, I would.
He's good.
Pick number 99. I want to know where he's lining up.
Third and 10. Blitz. Harrington is hit as he throws. It is caught by Keenan Howry, and Howry escapes, but he does not get the first down.
Little delayed blitz. Watch Lance Briggs just hit it full speed, and then he just clocks Harrington. Watch this hit. Oh, my goodness. Boy, he got helmet to helmet. You know, that ball's incomplete, too. The ball's incomplete. Keenan Howry did a nice job picking it off the ground, but he hit the ground. And that hit, like the one on Joel Event earlier at the NFL, cost you about 10 grand.
It was right there, though. It was angled off the side of his foot. And that is the second poor punt.
All right, Steve, and you're talking about Joel Event. And why don't we just give everybody an update? We remember back in the first half when Joel Event right there takes the vicious shot to the chin, helmet off. We know that he was tended to on the sideline for quite a while. They were working on the blood on the outside as well as the inside of his mouth. Well, after a while, they decided they needed to take him out of here. And as a matter of fact, took him to Sacred Heart Hospital. Joel Event is still there. He will not return as they try to reattach the inside of the flesh of his mouth to his gum line. Just hope he's going to be all right, Steve.
And Jermaine Chapman has had to play in his stead ever since, and he has played well. Jenkins almost picked off. Boy, Jason Nicola got high.
But the helmet contact, we've seen it tonight on two occasions. I mean, trust me, at the NFL level, they're fining people. At the college level, there's going to be personal fouls and player misconducts. You don't like to see that happen.
Trips to the right side, all clustered together. Jenkins looks that way. Now he will run. Ortiz diving for the first down.
Boy, and this is what Ortiz Jenkins has to do during this game. I think utilizing his legs. He does a great job, knifes right up the field.
As he said, he's got confidence again, and he said patience. And he said patience that it may not work right away, but to stay with it, don't stress, just keep after it, good things will happen. That's what happened last week when they won in three overtimes over Washington State, 53-47. They will run the football, and Oregon's defense all over it again.
Well, this is where Arizona has to take advantage of being in the plus territory now. Kroom just unable to get on track. Again, the swarming defense. Great pursuit angles by the Oregon Ducks that time, but you got to take advantage of your opportunities.
Ortiz, incomplete to Bobby Wade. Bowman with excellent coverage. The crowd really gets into it.
They got a cluster of receivers up top. He's going to call timeout.
It is third and 10 for Arizona.
And they're one-on-one again up top.
Jenkins this time looking left side. Incomplete. Again, terrific coverage by Steve Smith. He's shaking his head as if to say, you guys can't beat me deep. Palak has run to the right three times in this game. Now will do a straight-on punt towards the left corner. And it hits at the 8 and bounces into the end zone. Adrian Koch had a chance at it.
Ducks get the ball in, I'll say, fairly good position. They're unfamiliar with getting the ball at the 20. They usually get it up around the 40.
Their average field position this year to start is the 39-yard line. Opponents, the 23. 16-yard difference means a lot. Harrington. You know what? He just doesn't look smooth this half.
Joe DeVoya lines up as a stand-up defensive end this time. And see, they get a mismatch. They try to put a pullback. That's Josh Line trying to block him. You can't do that.
Second and 10. They're showing a blitz from the safety position, and he does not come. They hand off Maurice Morris. Oh, he is hit by Lance Briggs.
They are hitting at the point of attack. Tafoya, he ends up spreading it out. Watch Briggs shoot through the gap and just crush Mo Morris. Mo Morris ran a little high right there. Mike Bellotti said when he first came into the program, he said, Mo, you got to drop your pad level a little bit.
Arizona leads the conference in sacks. They also lead the conference in turnover margin. Third and 9. Harrington, deep. Almost intercepted, looking for Jason Willis. Curtis Doerr. What a punt this time. Driving Bobby Wade all the way back to the 31. And he is wrapped up immediately.
Great punt cover, too. They do a nice job in second in the conference in net punting. Great coverage right there. Well, if your defense gives you opportunities, you have to do something with it. Right now, Ortiz Jenkins has to get this drive on track.
Jenkins, play action. Trying to throw back. Now he must run. He's got some room to go, but he runs out of bounds, and he will lose. Arizona's offense has got to get going because their defense is playing a whale of a game.
They have to take advantage right now. Remember this, Ortiz Jenkins 7-0 in his last 7 starts on the road. He's got to make something happen right now.
All right, it is Arizona down by 4. Listen to this crowd. Farmer is going to throw. Complete at midfield.
We'll check him out from the end zone. They try to draw people in. He doesn't throw a real pretty pass. He does not throw a real pretty pass. Bobby Wade said, hey, that was a duck.
Quack, quack. Third and 14. Blitz from the right side and from the left. They dump it off screen. And Kroom goes down. Saul Pacheu was the only man out there to get him, and he made a terrific play.
Boy, you think Pacheu has made an impression on these 44,000-plus fans. Pacheu. He just reads it, does a great job. Watch Patu right here. He reads it, all of a sudden, runs underneath the blocker, makes the hit on Kroom in the backfield, takes him down for a loss.
And that crowd going, Patu. They're enjoying this one. Halleck runs to the right and angles it away from Keenan Howery, a marvelous punt that will roll inside the 31-yard line. Now it'll be killed at that 31. Boy, the back judge almost got clipped. The two top defenses in the Pac-10 Conference going head-to-head. Marvelous game, 14-10. Oregon has the lead. Just under 14 minutes to go. On first down, Oregon has been outstanding, averaging 5.5 yards in first down this year. Tonight, only two. So Arizona's defense, once again, terrific. That has been the Wildcat strength ever since Dick Tomey took over in the desert. Maurice Morris trying to get outside. He is hammered down, but he lowers his shoulder, and he gets about 5-6 yards.
Took a shot the other night like Michael Jolivet. His helmet shot about 20 feet in the air.
He'll take some shots from Jay Moore tomorrow. Morris cutting back inside, and he is knocked down by Briggs.
Set up as that tailback at that middle linebacker spot. He plays so deep. You see him come up. He just throws his shoulder into Morris.
Creates 1,500 yards rushing in high school. Also ran the 200 meters, 4x100-meter relay team. That kind of speed, and he's playing middle backer. Delayed blitz by Briggs. Harrington picks it up, throws to Justin Peel. First down, 45-yard line.
Justin Peel was instrumental a week ago on the same play. Just a little corner route back in the flat. Harrington, with time to throw, finds his man just over the outstretched arm of Antonio Pierce. Justin Peel really turning up the volume this year. 13 catches so far, 3 for touchdowns. A big fourth down catch a week ago against the Trojans on 4th and 3.
And that sealed their victory, 28-17. Harrington's best game as an Oregon Duck with 382. And again, it is Keone Frazier, Anthony Thomas, and everybody else over there to wrap up Maurice Morris. He will lose about a couple. Morris skipping to the outside. Maurice inside the 40 to the 39. I thought he might lose yardage at the line of scrimmage, but great burst to get to the right. And now he hurt his right thumb.
Goes out of bounds here, but at the point of attack once again, Steve, guess who? Number 99, Joe Tafoya, almost there. He just creates a lot of misdirection in that backfield, pushes Morris to the right, and all of a sudden he runs into the short side of the field of Oregon and Lance, or I'm sorry, of Arizona and Lance Briggs. The numbers on Morris tonight only averaging 3.5 yards.
Harrington looking for the option, cuts upfield, and gets the first down to the 30-yard line.
Option into the short side of the field. Arizona doesn't see that often. They over-pursue it. Harrington just knifes up, cuts it up inside. Corey Collins is in at that tight end spot up top, too. They like to go to him.
And Harrington looking his way. Now the defense comes from Joe Tafoya, and Tafoya forces him to run inside, and he runs right into Anthony Thomas. There is a late hit, though.
On the defense, half the distance from the end of the run, automatic first down.
We can see the late hit. Briggs dropping back, all of a sudden comes up. I'm not sure if he was the one flagged or not. This one might get a better shot here. Coke comes up, makes the tackle. Harrington takes a pretty good shot to the back of the head, a forearm to the back of the head, and that's what drew the penalty.
So now inside the 15-yard line, and the Ducks' right tackle may have moved.
Full start, offense, 5 yards previous spot, still first down.
Hey, here's a quick update, Steve, on Oregon tailback Maurice Morris. We saw him come off the field a few moments ago holding that right thumb. Well, the trainers looked at it. He has a cut between the thumb and the first finger. They looked at it. They said, hey, put a Band-Aid on that thing, slip the glove back on, and get back in the game.
A little rubbing alcohol, bite the nail, and run back out of the field. And they run Morris. Oh, look at this hit! Leaping the top, Brandon Nash.
Guys are laying it out tonight. Yes. In this game, the game for possible BCS implications, Pac-10 conference race implications, and that's just a big-time play. Brandon Nash flying over the top to the fullback, Josh Lyon, and then just nailing Mo Morris in the backfield. Watch him just fly over the top of the fullback, Josh Lyon, and oh, man. Well, that's a big-time play.
2 years ago, helping the team to a 12-1 record. Nash leaves the field. Second and 20. Harrington, play action, with time. Downfield, incomplete. No flags.
Watch him as they race down the field. The ball is really a good thrown ball. Incomplete.
We're here in Eugene, Oregon, with number 7 Oregon leading 14-10 over number 21 Arizona. Third and 10. Harrington will run it. Maurice Morris obviously will not get the first down. They just wanted to keep him inside the hash marks. I mean, the Ducks trying for the Rose Bowl this year. They have only gone to the Rose Bowl twice. Ducks have made it in since 1920. They made it twice in 57 and 1994, and in each of those years they beat USC in Los Angeles. They beat USC in LA last year. They need a win, keep the Rose Bowl hopes alive. Frankel is wide to the left side from 37 yards out. We started this game with a temperature of 55 degrees. You can see the steam coming off Antonio Pierce's head. Temperature has dropped to 37. Long drive by Oregon. They took 6:14 off the clock. Ducks lead by 4. Jenkins rolling deep, throwing deep, incomplete. Brandon comes right side now on 2nd and 10. Great crowd of 45,950 roaring. Jenkins fires it for a first down. Malosi Leonard to the 40.
Big time throw that time by Ortiz Jenkins. He really sidearms that one. He kind of slings it. Malosi Leonard doing a nice job coming back to the football, coming back to the quarterback, and then you see Sable trying to strip the ball out of the tackle. Nice play.
They'll go with 3 wide receivers. Arizona has been unable to run the football effectively. But, you know, Jenkins just seems to be a little more calm away from Arizona Stadium. It's very interesting, and we've seen him in some hostile environments. Probably his greatest game in his career was an incredible win 2 years ago at Washington. That flip into the end zone. But the drive was beautifully executed throughout that last 3 minutes by Ortiz. Malosi Leonard, nothing. Oh, Steve Smith is just playing another terrific game. He was outstanding at USC last week, and they have not burned him in this contest.
Steve Smith has stepped up tonight for the Ducks, and Ortiz Jenkins has been doing it tonight for the Wildcats.
No huddle offense. Jenkins 2nd and 10. Ortiz in trouble. Sacked. Jason Nicolau.
Cause you some problems. They went no huddle trying to take the crowd out of it. Unfortunately, the crowd got more excited. Nicolau right there, another sack for him. He came in with 4 on the night. Oh, and they create an awfully tough third down right now. 3rd and 16. You got to keep an eye on the clock. If you're Arizona, you're not going to get many more chances.
Bobby Wade to the left. Blitz, Jenkins trying to run, no chance. It's still Arizona football, but it's 4th down and about 19.
Boy, watch him. They're battling in there. It looked like he tried to. Oh, no, that was a fumble. I thought his arm was in motion. Oh, Oregon almost
covered.
Came down with it.
Now they run to the left, and he kicks it with the left foot. This guy would be great in rugby. It bounces inside the 35-yard line. Number 7, Oregon, trying to hold on and go 6-1 this year, 4-0 in Pac-10 play, and be the leader. Arizona trying to do the same. They both came in with identical 5-1, 3-0 conference records. 5 minutes, 54 seconds left in the ballgame. Arizona's defensive front has been marvelous in this game. They give it to Maurice Morris. He stiff arms Chapman. Chapman will bring him down, but not after Morris gets about 4 yards.
But Mo Morris, boy, I'm so impressed. You know, he just keeps chugging along. Nice gain on first down.
Morris jitterbugs for a couple of yards to the 41, needs to get to the 44 for a first down. It'll be third down.
Third and three. You have a run pass option here. If you elect to run and get the first down, you're just burning more time off the clock. Of course, it's gonna clock will stop with any conversion of a first down, but not for long. And this is an awfully big down for them if they convert tonight. They've been 6 of 15 tonight at 40%, but if they convert right now, they put Arizona with their back against the wall.
Harrington to throw quickly, and he gets it to Willis for a first down.
Well, they didn't feel good the last time they went down to the red zone. They came away with a missed field goal right here. That's good execution. That's a nice catch by Jason Willis in the back pocket. Harrington sticks it in there, and that's just nice under control execution.
Morris to the 40. Maurice struggling for a first down. You talk about strength as he goes over the 100-yard rushing mark.
3-2 going into the ninth, but the Yankees know how to win. Oregon trying to show opponents they know how to win at Autzen as they go for their 19th consecutive triumph here in Eugene.
I'm in Arizona right now. I tell you what, I would have contemplated using one of my timeouts right there after this down. If you stop them, you'll use one of your two remaining timeouts immediately. Dick Tomey over there talking to Dwayne Aquina.
Morris, not much. Pierce is there, so is Briggs. Jarvie Wooster also gets off the pack. Oregon leads as Sasquatch was able to get a ticket for the game.
I knew he lived up here in the Northwest.
Bigfoot. He needs a shave.
Keep an eye on the play clock. It's inside of 5 seconds.
Harrington gets it off on time. They run Morris. He will not get the first down. He gets to the 30-yard line, but that is it. Oregon leads it 14-10, fourth down and three. They've brought on Josh Frankel, the field goal kicker. I think something's up.
Little debate here.
I think it's going to be a pooch. I think it's going to be, I can't imagine them going for the field goal. It will be from 47 yards out. He has missed 7 of his last 11.
Only 2 of 6 past 40.
Watch for Peter Hansen. They do pooch it. And Frankel hangs it up inside the 10.
Great strategy by Mike Polani.
They have 2.5 to go, or Oregon takes the lead in the Pac-10. No timeouts left for the Wildcats. Oregon has 3, and listen to this crowd really pick it up here at Autzen Stadium.
And Steve, you mentioned the time of possession. Every time Oregon's won this year, their 5 victories, they've controlled the clock.
Remember, Arizona was down by 4 versus Washington in the flip play, the leap by the lake by Jenkins. Ortiz dumps it off. They'll lose about 4 here. They called it incomplete.
There's a flag. I believe there was a procedure call even before the play started.
A snap, delay a game, offense. 5 yards previous spot.
Now even closer to the crowd in the end zone where it'll be roaring. Look how close they are to that offense.
Brennan's right here. He's your possession receiver. Keep an eye on him.
Jenkins finds his man, and it is Brennan.
In the middle of that zone, right between the hash marks, and I'm sure that's what they'll do again.
Jenkins looping it up. Complete first down, Brennan. It's interesting how he goes to the guy who runs the routes that he wants. Oregon showing blitz. Here they come. Jenkins will run. He gets about 3 to the 42. Jed Boyce on the tackle.
He's Jenkins. It's noisy, but he's got it quiet where he's working right now.
No blitz. Jenkins firing it for the first down. And again, it is Brad Brennan who came into this game with 2 receptions. He has 3 on this drive. Completes Brandon Manumaliona. That will stop the clock with 1:16 to go. It is just a gain of 3. These fans aren't used to such drama. Oregon's average score during their 18-game home win streak is 40-17. It's 14-10 here. Brennan is in the slot left side. They've gone to him 3 times on this drive. Blitz comes from the left side. Jenkins has to throw it away. 3rd and 8. Mike Bellotti wants timeout, and he gets it here.
Helps them because they wanted a timeout. They didn't have a timeout. You'd love to call a timeout on 3rd down, 3rd and 8, just to get to the right play dialed up. There was some confusion on the part of Arizona.
Rams, because what they could do, they could call a play for the 3rd down, and if they fail, they've got a 4th down play to call.
Exactly. You're in 2-down territory.
Washington, Oregon State, both victorious this afternoon. The winner tonight has the upper hand in the Rose Bowl race. If Oregon wins, they've got an upper hand, I believe, in the BCS race, because the East Coast people have to start taking a look out west and see the power in this conference. 3 wide receivers. Jenkins shotgun. Blitz. Ortiz in trouble. Scrambles away and loops it. Kroom. Larry Kroom fighting. He is close to a 1st down, but I still believe he needs another yard. Timeout called by Oregon?
No, it's Gordon Reese, the referee.
They want to see how far they've got to go.
They're going to measure.
More than that, 1.5, and it's 4th down. Oregon has a great 4th down defense. I believe they get it. Clock will stop at 36. Get them ready, O.J. Oregon sets their defense. Dick Tomey believes he saw his Jenkins throw it, run for a touchdown against Washington 2 years ago on the leap by the lake in Seattle. Jenkins fires deep. Incomplete. Brennan had it on the numbers, but he was rattled by the cornerback.
Watch, I mean, the DB didn't even turn to look at the ball. He runs right over Brennan.
18 seconds left.
There's Brennan again. Watch him working over the middle.
Jenkins hangs it up. Incomplete, intended for Bobby Wade. Rashad Bowman. Great coverage.
Bowman stride for stride with Bobby Wade. I mean, that's a blanket. And that's a great defensive play. See how he had his eyes turned? I mean, he's going after the ball as much as the wide receiver. That's a great play by Bowman.
Jenkins looking deep. He's throwing for Bobby Wade. Incomplete in the end zone. 2 seconds left. Both the corner and the safety rolled over on Wade's side. They had single coverage on three receivers, and Jenkins only had his eyes on number one.
How many games in the Pac-10 come down to the last play today? Just about 4 games. This will be the 4th game that came down to the final play of the game.
Great coverage by Steve Smith. Stanford won with 4 seconds today. Can Arizona win with 2? Hail Mary left side. Jenkins unloads.
Oregon wins. Rally by Ortiz. Jenkins is left empty, and Oregon takes the Pac-10 lead. 6-1 overall, 4-0 in the conference, and there are three tied for second. Huskies, Beavers, and Wildcats.
And Steve, we said Oregon controls their own destiny. They got Arizona State next week, and it's going to be an interesting game.
So that's it for Autzen. Oregon wins it 14-10.